May you be safe. May you be happy. May you be healthy. May you live with ease. So you can stay and have your eyes closed. I'm just going to kind of keep talking because I'm going to do a variation of this. So I, like I say, this is one of my practices. It has been for a very long time, and I bring it in at times to my teaching when I work with people after trauma, after grief. Sometimes I ask for permission if I can bless them. Sometimes I just find myself, you know, put a blessing on an audience. I mean, it comes out differently. And looking at our core needs, I have modified this, and I think the one that I often use. So you can just see how this feels as you receive it from me to you. May you be safe. May you feel love. May you have hope. May you breathe with ease. May you be safe. May you feel love. May you have hope. May you breathe with ease. May you be safe. May you feel love. May you have hope. May you breathe with ease. So when you're ready, you can open your eyes or rejoin on video, if it suits you to just sit and meditate or sign off at this point. That is A-okay as well. This is all about best meeting your needs in this moment. And that's part of why I love this meditation, is it brings us back to this moment, and it allows us to remember that, yeah, while the future is uncertain and the day can even seem daunting, back in this moment, we are safe, and there is love for us to connect with and to feel, and there is a hope that we can reignite within us, and we have a right to be happy, even in the middle of a pandemic, and we can embrace our health, and even bringing back from living with ease to breathing with ease, we can take this breath and the next breath with ease, and as we do that, right, we're downshifting again. So I just wanted to take today and collectively downshift and collectively bless ourselves and collectively send out blessings to others. And then just have a conversation around that. And like I said, we don't need to stay for the full hour, whatever serves the group. But perhaps if anybody wants to share what that experience was for them, or if you think that this could be helpful in those times that we're getting pushed, because what we're really trying to do as leaders and as world makers is we're trying to ever expand our own window of tolerance. And then have more and more tools that we can stay within it, because that's the place from which we can lead others. That's the place from which we can inspire others. That's the place from which we can give hope to others. And that's really the place, I think, that from which we can just remind people of the resources they have, those inner resources, and that we can all remember how connected we truly are.